So in example one, it says, calculate the pH of a 0.0782 molar solution of calcium hydride. Now we know that calcium hydride is a strong base because remember, we have calcium, which is Ca2+, connecting with H-, our hydride ion. So what happens here? The two from here came here, the one from here came here. That's how we got calcium hydride. And what we should realize here is that there are two calcium hydrides in the formula. Now, this is what you need to remember when it comes to strong bases. For strong bases, you have to be very careful. We're going to say that this is not the real concentration of our strong base. You're going to say when you have strong bases, you have to look at the number of OH minus, H minus, NH2 minus, O2 minus. So you have to look to see how many of each you have in order to determine the real concentration of that strong base. In this particular question, we have two H minuses. And because we have two of them, we have to multiply this by two. That'll give us the correct concentration of our strong base. Okay, so you have to remember that. So for example, if I had CaOH2 and there was 0.100 molar of it, again, because you have two OHs, you'd have to multiply that by two. If you had calcium amide, you would have two NH2s. So again, you'd have to multiply the concentration times two to get the correct concentration. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna multiply the initial concentration times two to get the real concentration. Okay, when we do that, we're gonna get our correct concentration. That's the number that we're gonna plug in. So when we do that, and I'm gonna remove myself, guys, from the image so we have more room to work with. When we do that, we're gonna get a new number, a new value for our OH minus concentration. So here we're gonna get 0.1564 molar. That becomes our new concentration. So we're gonna say pOH equals negative log of OH minus. So it becomes negative log of 0.1564 molar. Now, some of you may be asking, but Jules, this is saying the concentration of OH minus. We don't have OH minus, we have H minus. How do they relate? Just realize that all four of these ions can be treated as being the same. They all feed into the concentration of OH minus. So OH minus is just understood as a general term for the strong basic ion of a strong base. So if I have two OH minuses, that's equivalent to two H minuses, equivalent to two NH2 minuses, same thing. So when we take the negative log of this, this will give us our pOH. It's gonna give us 0.81 for our pOH. But remember, let's pay attention. I didn't ask for the pH, I didn't ask for the pOH, I asked for the pH. So we need to use the next equation, pH plus pOH equals 14. Plug in what we know for pOH, 0.81. We need pH, so subtract 0.81 from both sides. So pH here equals 13.19. So that'll be our pH for this first question. Hopefully you guys didn't get lost by what I was saying. Just remember, for strong bases, you have to look to see how many OH minuses you have, H minuses you have, NH2 minuses you have, and O2 minuses you have. Their number determines the correct concentration of our strong base. And right now, what you need to realize is we only do this for strong base at this point. If we had a strong acid, such as H2SO4, that strong acid has two acidic H's. But we wouldn't need to multiply the concentration times two. Because when it comes to acids, the first H coming off is extremely strong. But the second one that comes off is extremely weak. And because the second H plus is extremely weak, we wouldn't need to multiply the concentration times two. So we only do this multiplication of concentrations when we have strong bases. Later on, when we deal with acid-based titrations and buffers, we'll talk about how acids play a role.